Today we journey into 6 games about grief and loss. Number 6 on the list is The Last Campfire, an August 2020 adventure puzzle game developed and published by Hello Games. Even though it's a puzzle game, there is also an explore mode which removes most of the puzzles for those who would rather just explore the land. This game follows the experiences of a soul named Ember who must help fellow souls called the Forlorn who have lost their hope as well as their purpose. Together, you will discover a beautiful wilderness filled with those who are lost, strange creatures, and mysterious ruins. The puzzles are environmental in nature, so you will have to interact with the world in order to climb cliffs, explore caves, or just traverse the land. There are other times where you will have a request to fulfill for someone you meet along the way. When Ember comes across a Forlorn, Ember speaks with them and helps the Forlorn find their meaning. The developers describe this as, at its heart, it is the story of rekindling hope in an otherwise hopeless world. The characters in this game don't speak directly. Their internal and external monologue are directed by a single voice as gentle as the surrounding environment. The puzzles vary in difficulty, with some being quite easy and straightforward, and others requiring a bit more thought to navigate. There are also collectibles to find, which provide a secondary story along the way. And while you don't get to know the backstories of the Forlorn, you become familiar with their feelings of being lost and confused, and you feel a sense of accomplishment when you help them find their light, but only when they're ready. The Last Campfire is available on iOS, PlayStation 4, Switch, Xbox One, and PC. Number 5 on the list is Lost Ember, an action-adventure exploration game developed and published by Moon Eye Studios in November 2019. You take the role of a wolf who is asked to assist a lost soul, which are called Lost Embers, to cross over into the afterlife. Along the way, you can explore the remains of a fallen world, and you can inhabit the bodies of different animals to help you pass over an obstacle or find secrets, such as crossing a body of water, reaching great heights, digging underground, or climbing steep cliffs. As you travel together, you begin to learn more about the culture and history of the two souls on your journey, making a simple adventure an emotional one. There was such an interesting dynamic between these two souls that changes as the game progresses. You, as the wolf, or whatever animal you happen to inhabit, do not speak. The narration comes from the little light beside you as he witnesses the wolf's memories of its life before and begins to put together the pieces, one scene at a time. The deeper into the history, the deeper into emotional connection you begin to have with these two. And once you complete the main game, there are so many collectibles to gather, mushrooms, relics, and animals to find that will keep you coming back to see more and more of this world and explore. Lost Ember is available on PC, PlayStation 4, Xbox One, Nintendo Switch, and GOG.com. Number 4 is Among the Sleep, developed and published by Krillbyte Studio in December 2015. Full disclaimer, it's considered a horror game, but it kinda has to be. The game revolves around a 2-year-old toddler who cannot find their mother. And for a toddler, what's more horrifying than that? There's no blood, no gore, just a frightened child and a teddy bear traveling along to find where mother might be. The areas represent places a mother might be found, albeit made much darker and unsettling as it would be through the eyes of a child who is afraid. A nice feature is you can squeeze your teddy for light and comfort. Teddy also acts as a guide for the toddler, helping the child recover memories to move closer to finding mom. I almost didn't play this game because of the fact that it's a horror game, and that's not really my jam. But the premise of this game intrigued me so much, I had to give it a try. In the bright daytime with the curtains wide open. And I was surprised at the level of emotion that I experienced in this game. It taps into our childhood feelings of being small in a big scary world and needing comfort from a loving adult. Having Teddy to hug, to talk to you, and to serve as a light in the dark was a quite fitting companion for this 2-year-old. And once you finish the main game, there is an additional backstory to play and a museum highlighting the making of the game, and I highly recommend visiting that for the alternate ending alone. Among the Sleep is on the Nintendo Switch, PC, Linux, Mac systems, Xbox One and PlayStation 4. Number 3 is What Remains of Edith Finch, which was developed by Giant Sparrow and published by Annapurna Interactive in 2017. This is a visual novel adventure that allows you to play as Edith as she explores her childhood home off the coast of Washington State to discover the family secrets and determine the mystery of why she is the only Finch left alive. As Edith moves from room to room in the home, you get a chance to experience the life of different family members through their stories, told from the early 1900s through present day. It is presented in a first-person perspective, which really helps you get a feel for each family member as you play through their final moments in life. You also help Edith come to terms with the losses she has experienced and understand more about herself in the process. Okay, full disclosure, this is one of my favorite indie games of all times, and I've played through it more times than I will openly admit. But that speaks to how wonderfully done this game is. It's considered a walking sim, but it's so much more than that. Each story is uniquely experienced, the gameplay mechanics are personal to each character, and the voiceovers are so well done. And for those who like to take in all of the small details of a game, there is so much to learn about the family that is all around you. Everything the developers put into the game was put in with intention, and it really helps to play through the game more than once to really soak it all in. It speaks to our desire to find purpose in death and in life. I highly recommend this game. What Remains of Edith Finch is available on PlayStation 4, Xbox One, Nintendo Switch, and the PC. Number 2 is Grease, a platform adventure game released in December 2018, developed by Nomada Studio and published by Devolver Digital. Grease is described as a hopeful young girl lost in her own world, dealing with the pain experienced in her life. Her journey through grief and sorrow is manifested in the colors of the land, as well as her dress, which gains new abilities along the way to help her navigate the land around her and bring color and life back into her world. Each area of the game represents one of the 5 stages of grief: denial, anger, bargaining, depression, and acceptance that Grease must go through as she heals and learns how to move on. She collects mementos along the way, which represent parts of her past, and she interacts with statues that serve to help her find strength. If there was ever a game that defined coping with grief and loss, this is it. Because, though not explicitly stated, nor is anything in the game really, the statues in each section, the colors of the world, and the obstacles in each level represent this on a symbolic level. And as young Grease makes her way from stage to stage, she gains more and more strength to tackle the challenges placed in front of her. There's not a lot to hurt you in this game, but you will have to figure out how to progress through sections, either through using her skills or triggering events in the environment. I haven't collected all of the mementos, but there is a secret ending if you do, which has encouraged me to go back and play this game again. Not that I need much convincing. Grease is available on PC, Nintendo Switch, PlayStation, and iOS. Number 1 is without a doubt Spiritfarer, developed and published by Thunder Lotus Games and released in August 2020. A management sim and sandbox action game that centers on Stella, who becomes the new Spiritfarer, whose task is to ferry spirits of the deceased to the afterlife. And I use the phrase centers on a bit loosely because while we play as Stella and are accompanied by her adorable cat Daffodil, we learn so much about the lives of the spirits that board her boat, awaiting their time to cross through the Everdoor. Our goal is to make the spirits more comfortable, build cabins for them to rest, cook food for them to eat, and fulfill their last wishes while befriending them along the way. Stella and Daffodil must also forage for resources, farm, mine, tend to livestock, help island locals, gather various supplies, and acquire new platforming abilities from the many towns she visits as she sails from island to island. In my real life, I work with people in their final weeks, final days, or even final hours of their life. Speaking with someone or holding their hand for the last time is not an unfamiliar experience, which is why I think this game speaks to me so. Being able to see the stories of someone's life through their eyes and listen as they experience what is most important to them is something that I appreciate, both for them and for myself. And in this game, we get to not only take care of the needs of the spirits, but also get to know more about them the more we talk with them. And this game even comes with a hug mechanic, which further bonds you and your passenger, provided they are in the emotional space to receive it. Spiritfarer is available on PC, Mac, Linux, PlayStation, Switch, Xbox, and Stadia. And there you have it, folks. We've reached the end of our journey into six games about grief and loss. Even though I counted them down, they are all great games, and I encourage you to look into them. Links are provided down in the description. But be ready with some tissues, because the conclusion of these games just might make you cry. And please be sure to leave a like if you enjoyed this video, leave a comment, and subscribe to stay up on more indie game goodness. And with that, I've been Journey of the Indie Journey, taking the road less traveled, and I will see you all on the next adventure.